Good morning, children. Today in EBS, we are going to start lesson 4, water, reading and explanation. Okay? Page number 118 and 119. First, watch the video of the lesson. Okay? Then take out your readers and you also read along with the teacher and understand the lesson, children.
Water. All living things need water. We cannot live without water. We get water from lakes, rivers and ponds. From where do the lakes, rivers and ponds get water? We know that the upper parts of mountains are covered with snow. During summers, this snow melts and changes into water. This water comes down in the form of streams and rivers. Sources of water. Rain is the main source of water. It fills rivers, lakes, and ponds. Some water goes into the soil. It is called underground water. We get underground water from wells, tube wells, and hand pumps. How do we get pure drinking water? Before water reaches our homes from rivers, it is collected in tanks and purified in treatment plants. Then, it is supplied to homes through underground pipes. At home, we get water from taps.
It may contain germs that can make us sick. We can kill these germs by boiling it or by using a water filter. Nowadays, electric water filters are connected to the taps to get pure water.
Water pollution.
Human beings are responsible for making the water dirty. We should stop making water dirty.
Dirty water is bad for our health. It is bad for the plants and animals too. Water is precious. Save it. In summers, many lakes and rivers dry up. People in villages do not get enough water. We face shortage of water in cities too. So, it is our duty to save water and use it wisely. You too can save water.
Follow the tips given below.
Turn off the tap while brushing your teeth. Turn off the tap properly to avoid leakage. Collect rainwater and use it for washing or watering plants. Use a bucket of water to take a bath. Using a shower is fun, but it wastes a lot of water. Do not throw the leftover water off your bottle.
Today we are going to start new lesson, children, lesson 4, water. Okay, hope you have watched the video. In the video, it's being clearly explained with pictures. Now, today we are going to do the part of the reading of the lesson and also I'm going to explain it. Okay? In the last two lessons, children, lesson 2 and lesson 3, we have read about food. This lesson, we are going to read about and learn about water. Okay? All living things need water. All the living things like plants, animals, human beings, all of us need water. Like how we need food to live, children, water is also important for us to live. We cannot, C-A-N-N-O-T, cannot live without water. We get water from lakes, rivers and ponds. From where do the lakes, rivers and ponds get water? Okay, we get water through pipes to our home through lakes, rivers and ponds. But from where does lakes, rivers and ponds get water, children? We know that the upper parts of the mountains are covered with snow. During summer means when it is very hot, children. Okay, the sun shines brightly. During summer, this snow melts Okay, melts means the snow will be change into water. So snow melts and changes into water. This water comes down in the form of streams and rivers. Okay, see, I will show you. This is the snow covered mountains, children. When the sun shines, this snow will be melt and it become water. See, it's becoming water and it comes down in the form of streams and rivers. One more picture is here. See, it's coming down in the form of river. So this river water is collected in ponds and lakes. That water we get in through taps to our home. Now next page, children. Sources of water. Sources means from where do we get water? What are the main sources of water? Rain is the main source of water. We get water from rain. When the rain falls, the water is collected in rivers, ponds and lakes. Okay? It fills rivers, lakes and ponds. When the rain falls, the rivers, lakes and ponds will get water. Some water goes into the soil. It is called underground water. Some of the water also goes under the soil. That is underground water. We get underground water from wells, tube wells and hand pumps. See, children, the rain is falling here. So rain is the main source of water. The water which we get on earth is from rain. It is the main source of water, rain. If there is no rain, then the land will become dry. So rain is very important for us to get water. Then this rain water is collected in lakes. The mountain water and the rain water is collected in lakes and also in ponds. Some of the water goes under the ground, children. That water we get from wells. Have you seen a well in villages? Rehti na body. Body mein pani rehta. Wo pura underground water rehta. It goes inside the earth. Under earth ke andar chale jata. And that water we get from wells. Tube wells. This is a tube well. See, ye pure khet mein pani dalte na. Aap gaye the village ko. Have you been to a village? There you will see this tube wells. This also we get water from underground. And also hand pump, children. Boring. Bore well, you say. No, not bore well. This is the hand pump. You have, this is, here is the hand pump, handle, which you have to do up and down, then you will get the underground water. This handle you have to just move up and down, then you will get this underground water. This, we get underground water from hand pump also. Did you all understood, children? Now, next, how we get pure drinking water? Before water reaches our homes from rivers, it is collected in tanks and purified in water treatment plants. Okay, from the rivers, see, from the lake, the water is directly, it will not come, children. It will be, it will go to the water treatment tank. It is collected in the water treatment tank where it is purified. Water will become pure, clean here. Okay, they will clean the water in the water treatment plants. Then it is supplied to our homes. Supplied, spelling SUPPLIED, supplied to our homes through underground pipes. Okay, it will come through underground pipes. Pipes are laid through which the water is connected to our homes. At home, we get water from taps. It may contain germs. Tap water is may contain germs because it comes through many pipes, children. So it may contain germs that can make us sick. So the tap water is also not clean, but we can clean it at home. How can we clean water at home? We can kill these germs by boiling it. You can boil the water and kill the germs that are there in the water, or by using a water filter. Nowadays, electric water filters are connected to the taps to get pure water. Okay, Now, see, by boiling also you can clean the water, you can kill the germs. You can use water filter also, children. Okay? Purite, many water filters are there nowadays, no? That also you can use. And one more option is there. You can connect this electric water filter. You can attach it to the tap. So, this the water is cleaned through electricity and it will come through tap. Tap is being attached to it, children. Okay? This is also one of the way of cleaning water that comes through tap. So, you have to do, you have to watch the video, children, and also do the reading practice from here. How we get pure drinking water. From here till here, do the reading practice and send it in the group when the settings change. And also, you have to do this activity, children. Page number 118, tick the activities that need water. Okay, the activities that need water, you have to tick. The activities that do not need water, you have to just cross it out. Does reading need water? No. Okay, don't tick, just cross it out. Okay, if you have to do swimming, you need water, so tick it. Like this, you have to complete this activity. Thank you.